Thank you for coming here on this holy and blessed night. Thank you for coming here to pray and reflect upon these sacred mysteries of the Lord's love for us that he pours out these days. And in particular tonight, we are reminded of some very great gifts that the Lord gives us. He gives us the gift of the priesthood, for it was at this Last Supper where he instituted the priesthood as this gift, this ministry to the church. We are reminded of the gift of the Lord himself in the Blessed Sacrament, in the Holy Eucharist, which he gave to his disciples for the very first time at the Last Supper, and which we receive again and again and again when we come to celebrate Mass. And we also celebrate the gift of the Lord's commandment to fraternal charity, as evident in the Lord's washing of the feet. And to help unpack some of these mysteries, or at least the essential theme that runs through all three of these, the priesthood, the Eucharist, and the commandment to fraternal love, to fraternal charity, I'd like to start just by reflecting on, some family memories a little bit. Several years ago, we had a big family reunion. It was, we don't have these too often anymore. My mom came from a large family. She came from a family of eight, and I have around 50 first cousins scattered across the United States. So we had this big family reunion. And my mother and one of my aunts, they put together this little book of memories of their family, when all the cousins' parents were children, is something to kind of pass on to us. And I still have this book, and every once in a while I take it out. It's interesting to read through some of the anecdotes, and this family had a pretty good time. There's this picture in it of my grandmother. Remember those old Groucho Marx things with the glasses and the nose and the mustache? My grandmother's wearing one of these, has a cigar in her mouth. And it must have been quite a party. But what's characteristic of this little booklet that they put together is that every single anecdote talks about times just when they were together. Simple things from picking vegetables in the land that they farmed, picking vegetables together, to other kinds of things they did as children. The book was really filled with that. It was filled with times that they just spent together. And if we think about the mysteries that we are celebrating tonight, this common theme that runs through every single one of them, the priesthood, the Eucharist, the commandment to fraternal charity, is all about people being present to one another and God being present to us. It's all about being together. It's all about being present. As I go around, the diocese and I meet people, a common question I get sometimes, especially from people who aren't Catholic and they find out I'm a bishop, well, what do bishops do? And I might think, well, really not much. But really, that's the truthful answer. because maybe the best way to describe a bishop or to describe a priest is not really what we do, but it's who we're with. And it's the time we spend with people. Whenever I've left a parish assignment and moved from one place to another, and sometimes I get these cards from people, and they will recount something. And it's usually just about an occasion where I just showed up somewhere. I didn't really, you know, do much, but I was just there, and I was with them. And somehow there's something powerful about an interpersonal presence and an interpersonal encounter that conveys the presence of God and conveys the presence of His love. And the spiritual fatherhood that is proper to being a priest is really just that. It's conveyed through the presence that we have with people. And that this fatherhood of God, you know, this love of God is present, that gives life, and it gives life through the personal encounters. And let's not discount these personal encounters that we have with people that many times might be the only time we see them in their lives, or in our lives. That happens a lot with us, you know, as priests. I recall one instance, for example, when I was a newly ordained priest, and I was maybe my first year of priesthood, my second year of priesthood, it was pretty early on, and I was taking my turn on call at the local hospital, so I was at the hospital that evening, and I was making rounds to some of the patients who were going to be having surgery the next morning, and I got a call to go to the emergency room. And there was a little girl who was on a train trestle across the river. And the train came. And she survived remarkably, except for the loss of the leg. Her leg just went over her knee. And I didn't see other members. I never saw the girl again after that night. They belong to a different Catholic parish, and of course their pastor followed up with the pastoral care. And I didn't see some of the members of the family after that night. But there was something about that time we spent together that changed my life, and maybe changed theirs as well. And it's not that I said anything brilliant because of what you say. I was just there. One encounter with one person, just once in my life, that makes a difference. And so what is at the heart of the fatherhood that's proper to being a priest or proper to being a bishop? It's really about presence. It's not really what we do. The better question is, Bishop, who do you hang out with? So you see how this presence reaches its culmination in the gift of the Eucharist, where what could be more present than God Himself, comes and changes bread and wine into His very body and blood to be with us and to be that abiding presence, to touch our lives, to touch our hearts, to be with us. And it is that presence of God in this amazing sacrament which completely and totally transforms our lives. And it's this presence of God in the sacrament that transforms our lives and enables us to live out this commandment to fraternal charity. And this charity, this washing of feet, so to speak, is not just something we do for someone else. It's not just functional. It's all about building relationships and bringing God to others through relationships. I think one of the great contemporary examples of this is the ministry and service of the St. Vincent de Paul Society. Because what is at the heart of their mission is not running a store and not just helping people with material needs, but forging and building relationships with the poor. So visiting the poor in their homes, it is really the center point of that ministry. It's these home visitations, and it's building the relationships, it's being present. We celebrate this evening an amazing threefold mystery. The mystery of God's love, the mystery of His presence. As we gaze upon this altar later this evening, we see an amazing transformation that happens when bread and wine are changed into the very body and blood, so that the Lord is with us and gives Himself to us. May our lives be transformed, so that in our relationships with one another, we can convey the presence and the love of our God.